Have you ever rolled down a grassy hill? Maybe in your front yard or at a park? You do have to be careful in these places and look out for cars. Can you imagine if the fun didn't have to stop and this grassy place to play went on for miles and miles? As it turns out, there are places on Earth just like this called tropical grasslands. These biomes are warm all year round. Best of all, they have endless space for animals to run and play. At first glance, these places look simple, just a lot of grass. But biologists will tell you when you see grasses, you know this is an area that can support many kinds of plant life. And that means more kinds of animals as well. Lots to learn about. Let's take a closer look at this unique neighborhood of our planet. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. Tropical grassland is actually a scientific name. It's a certain kind of biome, which is another scientific name. Ecologists have divided the Earth into many different biomes, depending on what it's like to live there. There are 11 biomes, and tropical grassland is just one. Some of the others include Arctic tundra, tropical forests, deserts, boreal forests, and marine. What do all of these have in common? Each of these is a place on Earth where a specific group of plants and animals live together in a similar environment. For example, plants and animals like penguins, Weddell seals, mosses, and lichens all live together in the Antarctic tundra. The cold climate and harsh conditions make it the perfect place for all of these plants and animals to live. Each biome has unique sets of flora and fauna that make it different from the rest of Earth's biomes. Tropical grasslands, also known as the savanna, is another biome with its own set of plants and animals who flourish in the warm weather, making their home in these rolling hills. Tropical grasslands can only be found in certain parts of the world. More specifically, they can be found on and along Earth's equator. The equator is an imaginary line that divides the Earth into two halves, the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. The equator is known for having the most consistent weather out of anywhere on the planet. While there may be wet periods and dry periods, the temperature doesn't change much. That's because it's constantly being exposed to the sun's rays all year long. Savannas are the most famous for their presence in Africa, but they can be found in other continents near the equator too, like South America, Australia, and Asia. Tropical grasslands are called tropical for a reason. Technically, we call the tropics anything that's within a certain distance of the equator. We mark this region on a map or a globe like this. These are imaginary lines called the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. They get their names from constellations. Forget your winter coat. Tropical biomes are warm for the entire year. How nice does that sound? Temperatures usually range from 68 to 95 degrees Fahrenheit or 20 to 35 degrees Celsius, no matter what month of the year it is. In addition to the consistent warm weather, precipitation also has a big effect on the tropical grassland biome. Rain is a prominent force here, and unlike the temperature, the amount of rain does change depending on what time of year it is. Tropical grasslands have very clear wet and dry seasons. During the wet season, which can last from 6 to 8 months, tropical grasslands receive heavy rainfall, sometimes up to 60 inches. This rainfall is important for replenishing water sources and supporting the lush growth of grasses and other vegetation. The dry season, on the other hand, sees much less rainfall and usually lasts for 4 to 6 months. During this period, the grasses dry out and the landscape can appear more barren. However, many plants and animals have adapted to survive during this time of year. Some plants have deep root systems to access underground water, while others, like the baobab tree, store water in their trunks. Now that's thinking ahead. The plants in tropical grasslands are incredibly diverse and have special qualities to help them survive in both the wet and dry seasons. The most common plants are various species of tall grasses, which can grow up to 12 feet tall. I mean, it is called a grassland after all. Some of the notable grasses include Bermuda grass, which is tough and drought resistant, and elephant grass, which provides essential food for large herbivores like elephants. I bet you didn't see that one coming. Besides grasses, tropical grasslands also feature scattered trees and shrubs. One of the most iconic trees in the savanna is the acacia tree. Acacia trees have flat-topped canopies and long, deep roots that allow them to access water from deep underground during the dry season. These trees also have thorns that stop herbivores from eating them. And don't forget the baobab. This tree is known for its enormous trunk that can store thousands of liters of water, enabling it to survive in the dry season. Baobabs can live for thousands of years and are a vital resource for many animals. Did you perk up when we mentioned elephants? We thought so. We love elephants too. You should know. We're already planning our next series about the animals of each biome. We're committed to bringing you the best educational content for kids, but we can't do it without you. Your donations are crucial for our work to continue. Support our nonprofit and help us keep the wild in the spotlight. Donate now and make a difference. Now, if you keep an eye out and look for movement in the tall grasses, you might find some stealthy and talented wildlife. Animals living in the savanna have some pretty incredible survival strategies. For example, lions, known as king of the jungle, live in groups called prides and rely on teamwork to hunt their prey, which includes antelope and zebras. Elephants, the largest land animals, use their massive tusks to dig for water during the dry season, and their trunks to grab food and spray water on themselves to stay cool. Giraffes, the tallest land animal, have long necks that allow them to reach leaves high up in trees that other herbivores can't reach. The cheetah, the fastest land animal, can reach speeds of up to 120 kilometers per hour or 60 to 70 miles per hour in short bursts to catch its prey. Other residents of the tropical grasslands include wildebeests, which take part in the Great Migration, a massive annual movement across the savanna in search of fresh grass and water. There's also various species of antelope, which can run at high speeds to avoid predators. These beautiful places in the world look so peaceful and untouched, but we can't take that for granted. We have a responsibility to live in harmony so our human neighborhoods don't interfere with the natural neighborhoods. One of the major threats to the savanna is agriculture. As human populations grow, more land is cleared for farming and livestock. This can lead to habitat loss for the animals who live in the savanna and a decline in the soil quality. The use of pesticides and fertilizers can also harm native plants and animals. Climate change is another threat because it alters the patterns of rainfall and increases the frequency of droughts, which can disrupt the balance of these ecosystems. Conservation efforts are crucial to protect tropical grasslands. People are working on creating protected areas that keep animals living in tropical grasslands safe. For a biome named after simple grass, it's pretty remarkable how much complicated life and beauty we find in the savanna. From bulbous trees to the majestic animals, there's always something amazing to see. By learning about these biomes, we can appreciate and help protect these important parts of our planet. Be sure to check out more resources on the Socratica Foundation website to continue your exploration of the natural world. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.